Now I'd like to talk about watercolor paper. There is watercolor paper and there's watercolor paper. There's one grade that is called a student grade. If you're just using it to practice making trees or rocks or whatever, that's fine. But I do not recommend that you start with a student grade paper. Start to learn with the high quality materials right off the top, and you will be much more satisfied as you progress. Typically, my favorite paper is Arches, although there are many other good brands out there. I am used to using Arches, and that's one of the reasons I've stuck with it. There is paper, it comes in different weights, 90 pound paper, 140 pound paper, 300 pound paper, which is my favorite for a 22 by 30 sheet, which is a standard sheet size. There's also 400 pound paper, and I quite frequently, actually more than most watercolorists probably, use 1,114 pound paper. The weight of the paper is based on the weight of a ream of 500 sheets. So for example, 500 sheets of 90 pound paper will weigh 90 pounds. 500 sheets of 300 pound paper, 22 by 30 being standard, would weigh 300 pounds. And 500 sheets of the 1,114 pound paper would weigh 1,114 pounds. Now, the reason for the high number on the paper is that those sheets are 40 by 60 inches in size. And I do a lot of watercolors 40 by 60 inches in size. And those require, the weight is distributed proportionate to the size. So a 1,114 pound watercolor paper out of 40 by 60 would be pretty close to 300 pound watercolor paper at 22 by 30 inches, again, depending on the size. So we have three different textures. We also have the hot press, which is really good for details. It does not have a very rough surface at all. It's quite smooth. We have cold press, which is my favorite because it's sort of in the middle. And the other one is rough. It's a rough surface. Rough is really good, for example, if you're doing an ocean scene and you want to dry brush across the top and have the light skip off the ripples of the watercolor paper, it's really effective for that. I prefer the 300 pound because it has enough thickness to control the absorbency rate, and you can control your timing, and I will explain this later on. Timing is everything in watercolor. The operative word with watercolor is control, and you develop control over a period of time, and you can't just achieve that over a course of a day or a week. It takes many, many months actually to become really, really good at watercolor. If you use 300 pound paper as well, I don't have to stretch it. And stretching can be a bit of a bother. And if you use 90 or 140 pound, you're gonna have to stretch it. And that means you're gonna have to get a tray a little bit wider than the narrowest dimension of your paper and soak that paper in there. If it's 90 pound, 2 to 3 minutes. And if it's 140 pounds, 6 to 8 minutes. And you can use a spray bottle and spray both sides of the paper very, very thoroughly. Use latex gloves, or if you're allergic to latex, a substitute for latex, to soak that paper. And you don't want to have fingerprints on your watercolor paper because the oil from your fingers will adversely affect some washes a little later on. So you do that, and then you tape it to a backing board of plexiglass or marine plywood, which is water resistant. There are other materials you can tape it to as well, polystyrene or gator board or something like that. Use a brown paper tape, such as what some people would refer to as butcher's tape. It's a wide brown tape that you wet about a quarter of an inch around the edge is what you want to cover with your paper. And the rest of it, it's about an inch and a half wide, depending on the width of the roll. And that is stays on your paper well overnight so that it dries and it will flatten, and you can paint on it the next day. If you want to paint immediately, you can wet the butcher paper, use a brush, the butcher tape, sorry, use a brush, and don't put too much water because you don't want it to remove all the glue from the tape. And cover your page about a quarter of an inch around, and then you will remove that with an X-Acto knife after you've finished your painting. So leave it on the backing board while you're painting, and that keeps it flat. With 300-pound paper, you do not have to stretch the paper at all. It it will ripple and roll a bit, but one of the things I do in order to completely flatten a painting, I have two pieces of melamine. They're quite heavy. It's kind of a really heavy plywood, and I put craft paper down, put the completed still damp painting on there. So what I do is I put the painting on, I rub the back of the painting very with quite a bit of water using a sponge or a paper towel, and just soak the back with water face down on the craft paper, throw another piece of craft paper on it, and then put the weight of the board and leave it overnight. And in the morning, that painting will be flat for you. You don't have to worry about the ripples any longer. So it's more difficult to do with a larger painting, but you need to have a piece of board that's going to cover and put lots of weight on there overnight. The other thing with the stretching of the paper is that if you wanted to paint right away, you could put the tape on and just start to paint before the paper dries. Do it while it's still wet, and you can continue with your painting, and it will dry flat for you once you've finished.